As President Biden marks 1 year in the Oval Office, we are continuing to check in on some of his key campaign promises tonight. One, education. From reopening schools in the pandemic to a plan to offer 2 years of free community college, Geoff Bennett has this report card.
As a presidential candidate, Joe Biden proposed historic investments across the span of an American education, from pre-K to college.
We need emergency support funding for our schools, and we need it now.
And as president, Biden's top priority, providing immediate relief to public schools shuttered and stretched to the breaking point by the pandemic, a COVID relief plan he outlined early on.
Look, we can only do that if Congress provides the necessary funding so we get schools, districts, communities, and states the resources they need for those so many things that aren't there already in a tight budget. They need funding for testing to help reopen schools, more funding for transportation so students can maintain social distances on buses. They need it for school buildings, for additional cleaning service, protective equipment, ventilation systems.
President Biden delivered, pouring roughly $122 billion into K through 12 education as part of the $1.9 trillion COVID relief package he signed into law last spring, sending students back into classrooms and making up for learning loss. Add to that the president in November signing a $1.2 trillion infrastructure package, providing money for schools to remove lead pipelines and expand broadband access. One of the president's most ambitious education proposals called for universal pre-K.
There's universal pre-K for every 3- and 4-year-old child in America. It's going to increase academic achievement in all children and give them an even start, no matter what home they come from, no matter how little they've been taught to read or they've been read to.
The $110 billion pitch for free, high-quality preschool aimed at offering early learning that research shows helps kids throughout their lives. But the plan, included in his Build Back Better Act, is currently stuck in the Senate. The president initially included in that social spending plan tuition-free community college, which he said would boost the middle class and help the U.S. compete with other countries. But in October, the White House revealed it dropped the proposal in a massive round of cost-cutting aimed at satisfying conservative Democratic lawmakers.
So that was really discouraging to hear.
22-year-old Pam Williams attends community college in Milwaukee.
If that would have got passed, I feel like it would have encouraged more people to go for a higher education. But now people seeing that community college isn't even something that I might be able to pay for just because of how expensive that is.
For now, the president says that proposal will have to wait.
I promise you, I guarantee you, we're going to get free community college in the next several years.
And for Americans struggling with crushing college loan debt, one Biden pledge sounded particularly promising.
I'm prepared to write off the $10,000 debt, but not $50,000.
Mr. President, let me ask you.
Because I don't think I have the authority to do it by Senator Pence.
During his campaign, he vowed to cancel $10,000 in student debt for every borrower. But for the past year, President Biden has chosen not to use his executive power to wipe out the student debt that weighs on some 45 million Americans. That's despite increased pressure from progressives like Senator Elizabeth Warren, and establishment types too, like Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer. Instead, the White House has been kicking the issue back and forth with Congress.
If Congress sends him a bill, he's happy to sign it. They haven't sent him a bill on that yet.
23-year-old Aiden Sova recently graduated with $13,000 in student loans.
Although I still am a general supporter of President Biden, I have to say that my frustration grows. I thought that within the last year of his presidency, he would at least ease the burden for me and all of the other Americans who are affected, particularly considering the context of the pandemic.
Federal student loan payments are currently on pause because of the pandemic and are set to restart in May. All told, President Biden proposed the largest federal investment in education in generations, much of it targeted to those who need it most. But proposing policies has been far different from passing them into law. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Geoff Bennett.